says, come on, hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to game number one of the Clan War between Team aiR and Team.SCA StarCraft Ascension. This is going to be a best of nine tonight, and it is going to be a pretty high-level play. So, first two players on the field here. For aiR, we are going to have Intense, our red Terran. And I assumed that we would be spawned in by now and I would be giving away the locations, but I am not, in fact. So, on the left-hand side of MLG Shattered Temple, we do have aiR Intense, playing Terran for, of course, Team aiR. And on the bottom of Shattered Temple, close aiR positions, we have Hummingbird, the green Zerg, playing for Team SCA. So, like I said, this is going to be GSTL style. It's going to be a best of nine, not best of seven. And, yeah, Every win is going to be a point, of course, and should be pretty exciting. But both of these teams definitely have high-level players. They have met before. Team SCA did come on top in the previous meeting between these two teams. But we'll see what happens this particular match. So, beginning of every game, very interesting. We have a supply depot for our Terran player. I would say, you know, that's pretty standard. Not going to see a planetary fortress rush or anything this game. And our Zerg player is, in fact, not six pooling a Terran, which is probably another good idea. We do have the Zerg player immediately scouting close air to see the Terran and turning his Overlord around in pretty record time there in order to not let the Terran find that position. And Intense is going to go ahead and scout close air first anyways, so he will get that information pretty soon here. How come there is not an SCV making this barracks? Oh, there he is. He is buried in there. Holy cow, I thought I bugged out in the first game. That would have been a disaster. But Intense is not making this add his wall off, actually, so pretty interesting. We do see a gas, so perhaps he's trying to hide exactly what his attachment's going to be. And Intense is going to go ahead and try to block that expansion with that SCV. Two drones, though, are going to be able to... Ooh, well, looks like microing one of the drones correctly, and Intense is going to go in, look for the pool. We're going to have the hatch drop, and the game is going to continue from this point. Gas is just now mining for our Terran player. There is no... Oh, gas just started for our Zerg player. No pool quite yet. Looks like it's going down right now at 15 supply. And in fact, no attachment immediately, of course, for the Terran player. Didn't make that tech lab, didn't go for any kind of Reaper expand. So, interesting that his barracks is all the way back here. Again, I do think this factory is going to drop somewhere in this location. Little gas steal from the Zerg player. Being annoying, not dying to that Marine. Gas has started mining for our Zerg, and the hatchery is on the way. Of course. We do have the factory being placed next to the barracks. I am so good at this, you have no idea. And Zerg doing a pretty good job of keeping that gas from being taken. So while I don't expect Intense to have taken that second gas in the near future here, it does keep the Marines back in the base from doing any sort of pressure. So we have a reactor dropping. Going to be a reactor Hellion opening. Obviously very popular, very standard at this point in time. And we have a really fast Roach Warren from Hummingbird at around 18 supplies, so probably a little bit of a Roach Rush coming up here. Already has 100 gas banked. Could be some form of a 7 Roach Rush, but no Queen or anything, so only going to be able to work with the larva off of these two hatches that they naturally make. No extended larva from the Queen. And look at this. Pretty impressive that he's dealing that gas that many times. Looks like we have a little pause here. Someone got a little bit of lag. Felt it too. It's kind of weird. No name popped up or anything. And the game continues. So, reactor Hellions indeed. Let's see what our Zerg player knows here. He knows only about the barracks. That drone has not seen anything else. We have 6 roaches already in production for our Zerg player. So, Intense doesn't look like he has seen anything beyond that pool start to go down. Has no idea this is coming, and he is going to make 2 Hellions. That tech lab is going down very quickly. So we'll see if he makes a Marauder and a Bunker here. He's going to definitely need one against these roaches. They are coming across the map very quickly. This is an incredibly fast set of roaches off of an expansion here. Very aggressive. So, both players, 34, 35 supply. Intense does see the roaches now. Has not yet started a bunker. Looks like he's going to go ahead and start one at the top of his ramp. May have to cancel his expansion here. That would not be the most ideal thing in the world here. Didn't decide to make that bunker. Decided he's going to hold it with SCVs, repairing these Hellions, but actually the SCV is not getting good surface area here. And the roaches do move up to engage the Marines and the Hellions. Hellions getting not actually great splash damage. Intense not targeting in a line necessarily. And supplies right now 40 to 30 already in the Zerg player's favor. So Intense definitely falling behind a little bit here. Continuing to make Hellions. Little too late to be switching these buildings to try to get out Marauders or something like that. So he may in fact have to pull more SCVs to help hold this. He's losing a lot of Hellions. 2 Roaches even left over. 1 with 5 kills, 1 with 1 kill. take a look at the workers killed tab while this is going on. We do have 5 workers killed for the Zerg player, so not that many. Denying a lot of mining time, killing off all of those units for Terran to be aggressive with, though, is really going to be a big deal here. So Marauder does come out with 2 Hellions. Intense has transferred all of his SCVs to his natural, starting to start mining again, but his production is pretty empty here, as he has no way to otherwise do this. So, harvester count, actually 24 to 27, so, you know, Terran player is not really that far behind. What just happened? 4 supply went down for the Terran player somewhere. Oh, he canceled these 2 Hellions, actually, so he's going to get Stim, and looks like he's going to go straight into siege tank production, perhaps, when this barracks finishes Stim. We'll have to see. Only 2 guys on gas, definitely needs that mineral production to go back up, and it looks like, we're going to see a lot more bio come down here for Intense. Just now dropping that tech lab, and you know, this is going to be a weird game for the Terran player. I'm sure he's not been in this position very many times, where he got roach rushed that fast. That was very peculiar to see. So worker count now at 38 to 30, and yeah, Zerg droning has 2 spines up, pretty good defensive posture, especially against only 2 Hellions, and the roaches actually get 1 picked off at the end there. Bunker with 2 Marauders in it, 4 defense, 4 Intense. Doesn't really have the gas to start another upgrade. He is getting a siege tank siege mode and making a lot of Marines here. And, it looks like Terran's not that far behind in worker counts still, 34 to 40. And siege mode is going to finish up 4 Marines in production at a time. A second gas has gone up for the Terran. And we have a lair and an evo chamber as our tech for the Zerg player. Lair just now finishing. Not really getting anywhere on a third. It looks like he is trying to knock down the gold rocks a little slowly. Doing what he can there. And the Zerg is poking with 3 roaches without speed. And this is actually a little bit weird to me. Of course, he doesn't really have the potential to do any damage. He knows there's a Marauder, at least one. And Intense really using this Hellion. Scout out the rest of the map. Actually doesn't check this base over here. Kind of weird. I think that's where I would expect the Zerg to expand if he didn't kill the rocks, of course. But Intense actually going to lose this Hellion, seeing that the gold rocks were being worked on, but not much else. So Baneling Nest and Spire on the way for the Zerg player. A lot of tech going down. Has 700 gas, so... could actually see a large number of Mutalisks come out, and I don't actually think we have an engineer.